Thank you very much. I want to start with just a little bit of background on Gatehouse Media for those of you who aren't familiar. So we have about 144 daily newspapers across the country, truly from coast to coast, small and large, big cities and small cities. We run about 569 news websites, so that includes all of those dailies, but then we also have business-to-business publications, we've got trade publications, weekly publications, and those 569 websites are not on WordPress. I'm not talking about our regular, what we call our newspaper.com URLs. Those are tied into a more traditional print-based CMS, and the content flows online, and it just works wonderfully every time. But what we have based in Austin, Texas, is our print design. So we centralized almost all of our print page design. We have a lot of our news leadership down in Austin. We have a native content sponsored advertising team in Austin. We have some development. Mainly what they do is maintain those 500 previously mentioned sites. And then the innovation team that I work on. And we got started just last year, really with the goal to support these local newsrooms in telling digital stories better. And then the other thing that we have in Austin is a bunch of people who, when it's 110 degrees, tell me, oh, it's not that hot. It's been hotter before. But one thing that I think really makes Gatehouse unique is just from our editors to our publishers, reporters, our readers, people are just absolutely in love with our antiquated print-based CMS. Whenever we buy a property, we transition them obviously over into our global template and we write a little article about, hey, this is our new and improved site design. And they give us amazing feedback, like this person who said, this is the new website with the same irritating pop-ups and videos everywhere? Or this other little bit of feedback that said, absolutely hate the new format, seriously considering returning to daily printed paper. I say bring it on, buy a print subscription, please. But the point here is that as a company, one of our missions is really to be doing journalism of impact. And because we own markets as large as Columbus, Ohio and Austin, Texas, but also as small as Wichita Falls, Texas and Ames, Iowa, we really encourage our reporters and editors to go after stories that make a difference in their community. And while our print-focused antiquated CMS works well for covering city council or covering high school football, when these newsrooms want to do a project that really matters and is really special in their communities, this old system of the ugly display just wasn't cutting it. We needed something that was truly digital first. So we turned to WordPress. What we do at Gatehouse is we have a completely separate special projects environment that runs in WordPress, and we're able to deploy a truly digital first experience in our largest markets and our smallest markets. We've been working on it for the last 2.5 years, really refining it over the past year, and we've turned it into a tool that works super well not only for our editorial teams, but also for our advertising teams. So phase one of this project was called Gatehouse Projects, and what we did is we set up through WP Engine a separate URL, gatehouseprojects.com, but what's really unique about our setup, and what's really, I think, helped it move forward, is that we pull in the very important information off of our regular newspaper.com URLs. So what we have on the attached to the back of each of those sort of old template websites is this JSON feed that can tell us their Gatehouse domain name, it tells us their Google Analytics tag, tells us their ID for DoubleClick for Publishers, it even gives us the path to the site logo. So what we do is we pull those JSON values out of the regular site and we inject them into the WordPress theme. So our sites are able to launch these special projects, even though it's living on a new separate URL, but they're able to get the tracking and ads just like they would be on their regular sites. The other thing that's really cool about this, because Gatehouse is such a large network, is that we can very easily syndicate between sites. So for example, instead of pulling the JSON feed out of dispatch.com, we can take the same WordPress created experience, swap out dispatch.com for the Peoria Journal Star here in Illinois, and we can be pulling their analytics and their advertising tags, but be displaying the same cool journalistic project. So that was phase one, and it was a huge success. And like I said, when my team got started last year in Austin, what we were doing is we were building custom experiences inside of WordPress to deploy into these markets around the country using the Gatehouse Projects template to not have to worry about advertising and analytics. And it worked well, but it was a lot of work for my team, and what we found is that there was an incredible demand in the field for sites to start using this. So phase two was making it a truly fully-fledged theme, and we built a ton of widgets in Page Builder that now allow sites to drag and drop the widgets themselves and create these very cool digital experiences. And what we were careful about, though, because we've seen in the journalism and the publishing industry, everyone has a tool, everyone has a game changer that'll help you tell digital projects. So we wanted to build something that was a very specific use case and had things that were intentionally included and not included. I think one of the things we've had the most resistance to is the sort of traditional photo gallery view. A lot of sites, when they want to do a digital project, they say, oh yeah, we've sent our best photographer out, and they've shot 150 photos, and we want to publish every single one of those 150 photos. But that's not the idea here. And when you see a truly great digital journalism piece online, it's been carefully curated, it's been carefully edited. And so by not including a photo gallery, we've encouraged sites to really be careful about what they're including. But we did include Leaderboard and Square DoubleClick for Publisher ad slots that load automatically based on the site tags. We included a full-width photo, video, and text, the sort of things that we've become used to seeing in digital long-form journalism. The other thing that we built is this sort of sticky sidebar, so as you scroll through the content, you can see on the left that pull quote stays. This is a Tableau, or actually Infogram embed. These things kind of stay with you. Just exciting little features that were really unattainable on the regular newspaper publishing platform. And then just a couple more use cases. This is from Topeka, Kansas, one of our smaller markets. This is from Daytona Beach, Florida, one of our larger markets. And then this is from Gastonia, North Carolina. And I love sharing this example, especially here, because the other thing that we absolutely love about having this special projects template in WordPress is that it's so easy to make your own. And when we have sites with a digital editor or someone with a lot of coding or CSS experience, they love that it's WordPress because it's super, super easy for them to go in and really make it their own. I brought with me a couple of case studies. Katie Moore from Topeka, Kansas. She had never, ever worked in any kind of digital. She's a reporter, true and true. She loves interviewing, she loves shooting video. She had never done digital work. They did a big project on Brown v. Board of Education, and Katie was able to use our platform to build a really, really cool digital experience that was so easy for her and so cool that she actually led a training for the other reporters in Kansas. And then again, to go back to North Carolina, Nick Dumont has a lot of experience in development and web design. He had a lot of experience with WordPress, but he hadn't worked with it in quite a long time. He is so amazed by the Architect platform. He loves the fact that it's easy enough for our smallest newsrooms, but it's open enough for him to go in and make the sort of custom sites that he's familiar with. And what's great about Nick is that he used to just build these off platform and he would publish them on their own hosting. Well, now with our platform, he can do the same thing, but he has an 8-hour head start because he no longer has to find the Google Analytics tags and he doesn't have to find the advertising info that he previously did. So then phase three was to turn this around and create a tool for folks on the advertising side. So again, we have our sponsored content, our native advertising team based in Austin, and they were seeing the kind of editorial experiences that we were building and that we were having sites build using the Architect platform. And so what we did is we created a advertising template that works in the exact same way. So when Gatehouse is approached by a national advertiser, they are able to go ahead and build these experiences just drag and drop in WordPress editor and create a really rich, really deep ad experience that was not previously possible with our more standard templated sites. The other thing that's awesome is that since we own it from start to finish, we've integrated Google Tag Manager really deeply in with these site presentations. And so we're able to pull analytics from start to finish that we own. We're not relying on a vendor anymore to tell us how our ads are performing. Since we've built the ads and we've built the platform, we now collect the data from start to finish, which has been a huge success. So we're also looking forward to sort of the future of phase four of this platform. We really want to build very specific flavors, I guess you could say, for our largest newsrooms like Columbus and Austin and Palm Beach. You know, I think a single template has worked pretty well for a year and we've had a lot of excitement around it, but we'd also like to look at what does a feature story look like versus an investigative story versus a sports story. So we want to build on top of that. I'm also really excited about integrating with Gutenberg. That's one of the things that I'm really looking forward to doing by the end of this year. And then we want to work on a RESTful connection because it is a little bit frustrating for folks right now to be putting content into the old system so that it appears in print and then also having to go and put it into WordPress. So we want to work through and make that a little easier. But that's kind of how we've been using WordPress at Gatehouse Media. It's been very, very exciting and it's been really a new thing for us. You know, this is actually the first time that we've ever really shared with the world the fact that we use WordPress just because we've traditionally been very much a print-focused company with small markets very focused on the print newspaper. And so we're very excited to be moving into the digital space and we've seen a lot of success with even very small newsrooms in Kansas creating some very cool digital stories on WordPress. So thank you very much, and I'll turn it over to David.